For their part, residents of towns in Batangas beyond the danger zone are volunteering to help evacuees, both humans and animals. Shiloh Francisco with the story.
Residents of Barangay Banyaga in Agoncillo, Batangas immediately fled their homes when the Taal Volcano erupted on Sunday.
Kitang-kita nyo, kami nandito sa bundok at kami nag-evacuate at kitang-kita natin kung gaano kalaki na yung usok.
They passed through a forest until they were fetched by a truck which brought them to Calatagan, Batangas. Among the evacuees is this baby who just turned 1 month old last Tuesday. Because they are settling at an evacuation center, the mother deemed it fit to call the baby Bakwit. Along with Bakwit is baby Bagyo, who was born during the onset of Typhoon Tisoy, and the two-month-old baby named Bulkat, who was born last year just when they were leaving for safety during an earthquake in Taal.
Para po mas maging matatag, kung maalala niya kung anong mga pinagdaanan niya, maliit pa lang siya.
Sana po ay maisip nila yung mga pangyayari. Takot ka ba? Lahat po naramdaman na po dahil...
With babies in tow, the families along with their neighbors stayed in a relative's resort.
Pag nandito kami sa ikang private o kaya beach resort ay nagkakaroon ng maganda ang mga bata na hindi katulad ng siksika yung mainit ang nagkakaroon ng mas madalas na magkaroon ng sakit ang mga bata.
And while Calatagan was spared from devastation, the resort canceled the bookings of tourists.
Kailangan ho nila ang tulong ngayon eh. So binibigay po namin ng aming kayang itulong sa kanila. Marami pa naman ng araw na susunod, babawi na lang po kami.
Other resorts are taking in evacuees as guests. In Sitio Sibukawan, Barangay Tumalim in Nasugbu, Batangas, a farm serves as a temporary shelter for affected animals. Among those is this dog, who broke its leg during the height of the unrest. More than 80 dogs were rescued along with cats, chickens, doves, and other animals. Other pets were surrendered by their owners as it's still unsafe to go back to their homes. Animals in the farm more than doubled since Sunday, but caretaker Felix Caraspa is not complaining as donations and help continue to pour in.
May pagkahirap pero okay lang naman po dahil masaya naman. Nakikita mo yung mga alaga na yung iba masaya.
Kasi syempre kumpanyo natin sila for the longest time. Tapos parang hindi mo pwedeng i-abandon yan.
Authorities said more rescued animals are expected to come in as various groups intensify their missions around the affected areas. Shiloh Francisco, VR One News.
Those who want to help can send cash donations to Alagang Kapatid Foundation. The bank accounts are now being flashed on the screen. This can be sent to BPI, BDO, Citibank, Metrobank, and PNB. Alagang Kapatid is also accepting in-kind donations such as canned goods, rice, blankets, tents, slippers, hygiene items, and face masks. Drop-off centers are located at the TV5 Media Center in Reliance Street, Mandaluyong, and at the TV5 Broadcast Complex in Novaliches, Quezon City. Batangas residents who evacuated from Taal Volcano's danger zone have been granted some small window hours to check on their abandoned houses and, in many cases, pets that were left behind in the frantic escape from Sunday's eruption. Romel Lopez is in San Nicolas to tell us more about this. Romel, kamusta dyan?
Yes, Robbie, that was right. I know residents were given few precious hours to check on their properties and their belongings after the Taal volcano erupted. Although they were very much aware of the tragedy's aftermath, nothing prepared them for what they saw today.
Dead fish were scattered all over the shore of Taal Lake in San Nicolas, Batangas. Owners had to abandon their fish cages during the height of Taal's volcanic activity.
Poblasyon at abilo ay ayos pa po naman ang kwan dito. Wala po naman kami nakita mga, although may mga patay na isda sa labas, pero yun po nasa cages, buhay pa po ang mga anlaman.
The local government had given residents window hours from 6 a.m. to 10 a.m. to return to their respective houses. One of them was Puring, who wouldn't help but feel emotional.
Hingi na lang ako ng kami ng tulong para mabubuhay ang bahay ko. Mamatay lang ako ng misis ko.
Leo used the window hour to clean the heap of ash on the roof.
Bung namin yun ang abo. Nag-alis po kami kasi kahit pinagbabawal po, eh mahirap naman po baka matuluyan po yung mga bubong namin. Kasi minsan-minsan po umuulan. E kaya nagbabawas po kami ng nasa bubong.
Roy attended to his herd of goats, some of which he's planning to sell to make up for financial losses due to the calamity.
Kung may iwanan din lang namin na hindi mapapakinabangan, buti pa ibinta na lang.
When the clock struck 10, residents had to leave.
For some, 4 hours weren't enough.
Namayat po, sapagkat minsan lang po namin itong napupuntahan. Kung makakadalo kami rito, minsan lang po sa maghapon kung may hindi pa namin napupuntahan.
Total lockdown was implemented immediately after the window hours, which according to the authorities will only take effect today. In the coming days, nobody will be allowed to go back to the danger zones.
Robbie, just to give you an update, Tagaytay Tourism Council has already released a memo allowing restaurants and hotels to operate as long as they can assure or ensure the proper hygiene and sanitation in their establishment. Safety of the customers as well as the employees also have to be prioritized. Robbie?
That was Romy Lopez reporting live from San Nicolas, Batangas. As more schools are used as evacuation centers, Education Secretary Leonor Briones says there is growing need to find alternative facilities lest students compromise their own access to classes. Briones says an estimated 2.4 million students have been affected by Taal's eruption. She adds that defaulting to schools as evacuation sites is understandable, but it has also created a strain on an already limited 200-day school year.
We are trying to solve the problem of the learners whose classes have been suspended by negotiating with the local government to involve local governments, involve the governors, the governor, the mayors, and so on, so that they can identify spaces where they can put up temporary shelters for the evacuees.
DepEd Regional Director Wilfredo Cabral says nearly 240 schools have been taken over as evacuation centers for some 14,000 people fleeing Taal's eruption and its resulting ashfall. The Education Department has ordered school districts to accept students from affected areas even without transcripts or documentation. Government has meanwhile extended a loan assistance program for affected teachers.